Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 portfolio video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignertechtips.com. Well, yesterday we put this little portfolio with a filter here together, and I've had a couple of questions from people, one of which was, well, we've got three columns here, I want four columns, or I want two columns, or I want six columns, whatever. We'll address that today. It's really easy. But there's also a little bit of error in the code that we'll sort out. So the first question I got is, I want to change this from three to four columns. There's one, two, three, and we want four. It's really easy. So if we open our HTML file for this site and roll down, here's all our filter items, our thumbnails, and at the moment we've got them on a large screen, which is what I'm using to record this video. It's probably extra large actually. We've got them size 4. Now, Bootstrap Columns, let's just get something up where I can show you this. Let me just pause a minute. Okay, I've just pulled up a little template that I use for demonstrating rows and columns. Bootstrap's made up of the viewable area here is made up of 12 elements. So you can have sort of 12 columns. You can have 12 single columns, 6 double columns or columns of 2, 4 columns of 3, 3 columns of 4, 2 columns of 5 with a bit left over, etc., etc. But you've got to think of it as being made up of 12 elements, and we're in a container here, so it's not stretching full screen, but this is the full width. So you see the 12 there, that's the full width, and you can mix and match. You can have a column of 1, a column of 3, and what have you, and you can use certain spacing factors: column end, column center, column start. And with the new Bootstrap 4, you've got some spacing options. You can justify the space in between, and you can center columns and what have you. It's really easy. But just to explain that briefly, you want to think of your Bootstrap viewable area as being made up of 12 single columns, 12 columns of one, if you will. So if we go back to our thing here, we've got three columns here, so that's three columns of four, because everything's got to add up to 12. Four and four is 12. So if we go back to our brackets, as you can see, we've got columns of four. Now that's displaying on large devices, this is displaying on medium devices, that's displaying on small devices, and that's displaying on extra small, which is 6, and 2 6s are 12, so there'll only be 2 on small sizes. If we go back, if I reduce this down, right, see, I'm seeing a problem there already with these images. On extra small, it's going down to 1. Should be going down to 2 as it's reducing down, so we'll fix that as well. Okay, so that's just a brief overview of the column structure of a Bootstrap. So you've got to think of it as this area being 12 elements or 12 columns, if you will. So to change this from 3 to 4, you've probably figured it out yourself now. What I'm going to do is I'll use the replace feature. We've got to change the 4s to 3s, because 4 3s are 12. It's going to get complicated with 3s and 4s. 4 3s are 12, so that will display 4 in a row. And we've got a row going on here, so after 4, or after the number that fills up the row, if it's 6 and 6 and you've got another one, the next one will be on the next row. So I'm going to use the find and replace feature with Divi brackets here. So I'm just going to copy our row structure making sure I've got no other rows that've got that actual structure on it, because it will replace them as well, and I don't. So that's fine. So I can use the replace. So I'm going to copy that, Control C. I'm going to go up to find. I'm going to go down to replace. And it's put it in there already for me. And where it says replace with, I'm going to put it in there, and I'm going to change the fours to threes. And I'm going to replace all. Saves me doing each one. Now they've all been replaced. All the fours have changed to threes there. Now save it. Control S. Let's go back to the site. Now when I refresh, instead of three columns, we should have four columns. There we go. And you see that there's a problem here with these images. And I know what it is. I saw it just now when I was looking at the HTML. You know, there's no gap in between. I mean, that looks okay, but that's not quite what we want. So if we go back and go down, here's the problem. Image responsive. Now that's a Bootstrap 3 class that works with Bootstrap 3. For Bootstrap 4, they changed it to image fluid. So what we've got to do, I'll do the same thing with the replace here, is copy it. Find, replace, and I've got to replace it with image fluid, which is the new Bootstrap 4 term. So that's now replaced all of those. Quick save, Control S. Now when I refresh, hopefully these should be square with a little bit of gap between them. There we go. That's a bit more like it. Make sure everything's working. Okay. That works well. But now we've got less or more thumbnails. It's kind of, I'd rather see this central here when there's two or three of them. And even when there's like that, I'd like it to be a bit more sort of centralized, a bit more organized. We can do exactly the same as we did with this, with that lovely new Bootstrap 4 Justify Content Center. So here's the row we want to work on, and we did it to this one up here. So if we just copy this over, Control C to copy, Control V to paste, Control S to save, and I'll just refresh, we'll put it back to normal. Now when I select on the text, as you can see, they're all nicely aligned in the middle. It's got equal space either side, which to me looks a little more professional. And even when there's an odd number, well, that's an even number, but I mean, not the same number on both rows. It's centralized, and rather than having just two stuck over there. So that's fixed a few issues there. So I hope you found that useful. I don't think there's anything else I wanted to cover on that. Let's see how it shrinks down. So let's hit the F12, Chrome Inspector Tools, and hit our responsive button here. And well, that's iPad. Let's have a look, see. iPhone 10. Make it bigger so we can see what's going on. Yep, that's fine. What about a small one, iPhone 5? I think that's about as small as it gets nowadays. Yep, that's going to work fine too. Excellent. Okay, so I think we're there. Like I say, it was on the iPad. That looks pretty good. That's fine. So that seems to have worked out absolutely fine. Just wanted to do that so you, if you had added this to your site, that you could edit it and make it work responsively. And add whatever columns you want. I mean, you can go stupid, you can have 6 columns if you want. Now you know how easy it is, let's just do that quickly. Let's copy this. And replace. And how many times does 6 go into 12? 2. So it's going to be 2 if you want 6 of them across. And let's replace all. There we go. Save it, Control S, back to the site. Now when I refresh, we should have 6 and 6. There we go. Like I say, really easy. So I hope that answered your question of how to customize the amount of columns, and that is sort of basic Bootstrap 4 stuff, but Bootstrap 4 and brackets does make it very easy for you to do that. So there you have it. I hope you found that useful. If you have, please like and subscribe. If you're interested in web development, take one of our courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there. So once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.